Namaste, I'm Smita Jayakar. We are going to discuss why do we need a living guru. There are lots of people who come to me and they say, ma'am, we have a guru, but he's not in the physical form anymore. So why do we need a living guru? The answer to this is, a living guru is like a powerhouse. To tell you what is right and wrong, you need somebody living in your life. Now, talking about me, I'm a believer of Sai Baba, Shirdi. So the past 35 years, we have been going to Shirdi very regularly. I've been praying to him. He is my first guide and master. Had he been living, I would have never gone searching for a living guru. I was never sure whether Sai Baba was actually talking to me or no. I had nobody to ask where have I reached in my spiritual growth. I need somebody to actually talk to me in a physical form and tell me this is what you're doing is right and that is what you're doing is wrong. So you need some living form to relate to. Besides, a living guru has the power also to take your karmas away from you. Not all, but a lot of your karmas are absolved by a living guru. That does not happen with a guru who is not in a physical form. And I always wonder that every time anything you do, we always take an opinion of others. Even a mundane thing like cooking. When you cook something, you ask somebody, please taste, is the salt okay? Please taste this, is the spice okay? Don't we do that all the time? Besides, according to Indian mythology, all our gods had a guru. Like Lord Shiva had his wife Parvati as the guru. Parvati had Shiva as the guru. Lord Dattatreya, the Trimurti, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. He made 24 gurus in his lifetime. So if the creator himself needs a guru, then why do we fight shy to have a living guru? Every time, whenever you're learning something, you need someone to guide you if it's right or wrong. Now, if you want to learn dancing or singing, do you think you can learn this by just watching videos or listening to audio cassettes? No, not possible. You have to have a living master who can tell you this step is right, that note is right, don't we? So when it comes to your own life plan, how do you think you can do it on your own? You have to have a guide who will constantly tell you this is to be done and you are on the right track. You have attained this much. You have achieved here. You do need someone who constantly guides you. Again, there are so many people who say that we have one living guru and we do not want to change. According to me, I feel every time you need to step up, you need to change your guru. If you're in the first standard, you can't have your first standard teacher teaching you something in the 10th standard. No. You do need to change your guru. Similarly, after school, you go to college. After college, maybe you want to learn painting, you want to learn computer science. You go to different directions. You can be loyal to one guru, but please do not restrict your growth by not going to other masters. Because each master has its own energy. Each master has something to offer you, something different. So you are stopping your own growth by not going to other gurus or masters. You may be loyal to your first master. Like if you leave your school, you will always say, my school leaving certificate is so and so. Though you may have taken singing, music, computer science classes from somewhere else. It's exactly like that. Be loyal to your own guru, but please do not restrict your growth if somebody takes you to another guru or another master. It's like going to a temple, going to a church. Don't we go to various churches? Don't we go to various temples? In Hindus, we have so many gods. We all go to so many gods. That time we never think, oh, I'm going to Ganesha temple. How can I go to Shiva temple? How can I go to Hanumana temple? Don't we all go everywhere? Why? Because each temple has its own sanctity, has its own vibrations. You get different things from different places. Do not restrict yourself by going to different masters. Again, coming back to a living guru, this is why it's very important to have somebody living to hold your little finger and guide you and take you on that path. Again, quoting Sant Kabir, who was an Indian saint, he also says this, that Guru Gobind Dou Khade Kaake Lagu Paaye, Balhari Guru Apne Govind Diyo Bataaye. What it means is, if there is Guru and if there is the Lord, Govind is Lord, if both of them are standing in front of you, who will you offer your pranams to? What Kabirji says, you'll offer your pranams to the Guru because he is the one who showed you the way to Govinda, to the Lord. So the Guru is the ultimate and the most important person in your life. That is the need of a good living Guru. Because God per se, nobody knows. God is unknowable. He's not unknown. He's unknowable. You will never know what God per se is. You only know God, or a little bit of that little essence of God, you only know through your Guru. Your master will show you the essence of God, or if you have an experience of God. God per se has no existence at all. No one has seen God. You have seen forms of God, just like electricity. Have you seen electricity? No one has. You only see the light working, the AC working, the refrigerator working, isn't it? And then you say, oh, there is electricity. But nobody has seen electricity per se. That's exactly what God is. No one has seen God and no one will be able to see God. So you only experience God through the living Guru, not otherwise. So my dear friends, do not hesitate to have a living Guru. Namaste.